and treating it as a sacred document. It will adhere to its implementation without any deviation. Every department of the government will keep a copy of it to make sure that all promises are delivered. In today's context, one would realize that the ideology of the late Dr. Y.S. Rajasekhar Reddy Garu, former Chief Minister of the erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, which essentially centered around focusing governance and exploring ways to help the poor, needy and destitute, is perhaps more relevant today than ever. It is in the keeping with this outlook that the incumbent government is evolving an integrated welfare agenda, Navaratnalu. Excuse me. Consisting of 9 themes. The themes are YSR Raitu Bharosa, YSR Arogya Shri, Amma Odi, Fee Reimbursement, YSR Pensions, Housing for All Poor, Youth, Employment and Job Creation, YSR Asara, YSR Cheyuta, Phase-Wise Ban on Liquor and Jalayagyam. Effective implementation coupled with robust monitoring, progress monitoring of these themes will be the prime agenda for my government in the years ahead. The scheme comprises 9 welfare themes benefiting different segments of population and cutting across various sectors. Let me highlight these themes in a greater detail as they are going to be the cornerstone of my government's welfare agenda. The top focus of my government would be farmers' welfare. Totally committed to the welfare of the farming community, my government has plans to bring about a transformation in the agriculture sector, which hitherto has suffered to an extent by the unpredictable weather, and treating it as a sacred document. It will adhere to its implementation without any deviation. Every department of the government will keep a copy of it to make sure that all promises are delivered conditions, and to a larger extent due to incoherent policies. With about 62% of the population still wedded to agriculture, my government considers that its primary duty to attend to their interests and well-being. My government is seriously concerned about the farmers who are being exploited in various ways, including supply of spurious seed. My government is planning to set up a state farmers commission to delve deep into the farmer-related issues and bring in reforms. The proposed mission will look into the policy and implementation issues in the agriculture and allied sectors. The much talked about linking of agricultural activities with the MGNREGS stands elusive even today. My government will explore ways and means to evolve a policy that will ensure availability of agriculture labour during the season to bring down the cost of cultivation. As promised, my government will provide Rs. 12,500 per annum through the